Hi everyone, my name is Sleep, and today I'm going to be doing the Reading Rush wrap-up, and I'm super, super excited. By the way, before you start watching this video, I'm hosting a giveaway on Twitter for absolutely no reason. I just really felt happy, and I feel like I really wanted to give back to you guys, so I decided, why not? I am going to host a giveaway on Twitter. So yeah, go check out my Twitter down there. You just have to follow me and retweet, and then an extra entry is be subscribed on my YouTube channel. As you guys know, in my wrap-ups, I don't like going in depth into books because I do not like doing full reviews. I just go very briefly over what the book is about, and then if I did like it or not, and some positive aspects. So let's just get started. The first book that I read was The Past and Other Things I Should Say Buried by Sean David Hutchinson, which is the author of We Are the Ants, which is one of the books that I really, really loved. And this book, it talks about a girl who is buried, but then another one of her friends digs her back up. So then, let's say, like, we don't really know if she is like a ghost or she is a human. We just know that she was digged up, and then she basically was digged back up, and she just roams around the city, and nobody can see her because people can see her. Like, no, she has to hide because even though she is dead, like, nobody can see her around because living humans can actually see her walking around, which makes this story so fascinating and so fun. It's such a good adventure, and I gave that book 4 stars. Next book that I read was Love From A to Z by S.K. Ali, and this talks about this girl called Zeynep, and she has some confrontations with her teacher because her teacher is stupid and he treats Muslim students really bad, and then gets suspended because of the professor's stupid attitude, which got me fiery inside. And she goes to Qatar, Doha, to visit her home. In Doha, she meets this guy called Adam, who has multiple sclerosis, and that, like, really takes over his life. But the thing is that, like, Adam's mom died, and he is trying to keep company to his little sister and be like a good father, because his father is alive, yes, but he's really, really grieving. So the problem is here is that because Adam's father is grieving so much, he tries to hide that he was diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, and it's a very, very serious problem. So this is very hard to hide. But then with both of their problems, they find Zeynep and Adam find themselves together, and it is such a cute story. But I wasn't completely, like, into it. At some point I got bored, at some point I didn't care what the characters had to say. It just wasn't my favorite book, so I ended up giving it 3 stars. And In Betweens by Tania Boteju, and this talks about a girl called Nima, who has a straight girlfriend, who, like, they live in Bridgetown, which is a very suburb, like, really normal area, nothing's happening. But then one day she goes to a place where there's a lot of drag scene, and she finally finds drag scene and how fascinating it is and how magical it is. And then she ends up meeting, like, macho drag kings, not only drag queens, and for her it's so fascinating and eye-opening, and it really blows her mind. And then that results in her interest of her part towards this scene. This is a really, really, really good story of, like, self-acceptance and self-love and just having fun, a lot of fun. And this was like something like Judy Blume meets RuPaul's Drag Race. So if you like any of those, you most probably do like RuPaul's, you should read this book. I gave it 4 stars. It's definitely a summer, like, recommend that I do, because it's just a very light read. At the same time, of course, there's some more serious aspects, but overall, like, I remember it in my head as a light read. I then read For Everyone by Jason Reynolds, which is a, like, a 30-minute audiobook about, this is like a text. Jason Reynolds talks about being a kid and dreams and not, like, giving up, and it is so inspirational, so inspirational. I gave 2 books 5 stars this week, and this was one of them. Totally, of course, I gave this 5 stars because it is so incredible and it gave me so much power to... I already know exactly what I want to do in my future, but this gave me that click of power even more. And thank you so much, Jason Reynolds, for writing incredible. If you haven't read any of Jason Reynolds' books, I've already read 3 or 4. They are all incredible, so you need to pick up at least this one, which is called For Everyone, because it is a very, very quick read and a good way to start Jason Reynolds because you instantly fall in love. It's Meat Market by Juno Donson, and Meat Market was by far my favorite book of the readathon. I actually started reading Meat Market before the readathon started, and Meat Market talks about this girl called Jaina, Jaina Novak, and she wants to enter. She's like, one day they go to this amusement park and a scout finds her. A scout is someone who works around like different locations where a lot of beautiful people or teens are found, let's say it this way, and then scouts them to bring them to their agency. I'm talking about modeling, by the way. And then, so yes, Jaina is scouted and she ends up starting this modeling career, but we end up learning that modeling isn't all that fun and all that beautiful and all that glamour. And if you guys don't know, I'm already signed up for 2 agencies like 2 years ago. I was rejected, and right now I really want to be agented again. Like, I really want to try to get into an agency, but at the same time, y'all, I love my image, I love myself, and I'm scared that me getting into the modeling industry like will affect more me in a bad way than in a good way. Like, oh, all the people, all everyone saying that I'm pretty, all the attention, that's good, I guess. But at the same time, I'm really scared that I put more and more pressure on myself to be beautiful and forget the true essence of my beauty. So this book really, really made me think. And if you like modeling, and if you just like modeling world or fashion, or I just really, really love this book. If you like YA books that feature traveling as well, traveling best friends, boyfriends, like, you need to read this book. You definitely need. People have been sleeping on Juno Donson. The last book that I read was called Cocky, which is a gay romance, of course. It's called Ballsy, and the actual subtitle is Cocky, which I actually found it so funny, so I was like, okay, what is this about? So this is about a guy called Sam who used to live in LA 10 years ago, and then he's back at LA, and he used to have this boyfriend, and they end up like reconnecting, and they end up 10 years after just meeting again, and it is such an explosion of emotions and sex and incredible sex scenes. And I listened to it on audio. It was my first time listening to Smut on audio, and I actually tweeted about it because it was incredible. I really, really loved it. I didn't feel a pinch of embarrassment at any time to be listening to it like on the street, whatever, because I was listening to my audiobooks everywhere. So yeah, I'm not gonna go in depth about what is this book about. Just if you want a good smut about like boyfriends that were boyfriends 10 years ago, and then they are boyfriends, and then they meet again after 10 years, you need to read this book. I completed all the challenges except the Bookstagram challenge and the read 7 books. As you guys can see, I only read 6. At this point, like yesterday, I still did have time. Yesterday was Sunday, today is Monday. I did still have time to read another book, but I honestly didn't feel like it, so I wasn't going to force myself just to finish another challenge. Thankfully, I'm past that stage where I would feel bad if I hadn't finished all the challenges. I'm just really, really grateful that I actually finished 6 books. That is incredible. Don't forget to join the giveaway, and please subscribe to my channel because I'm really trying to grow it. I have some big, big, big surprises coming in August, and y'all are not ready, and I'm not ready. So yes, let's do this together. I love y'all so much, and bye!